Notice this problem is set up a little bit different than the previous problem we looked at in the last video. This time, we're not given the three interior angles. Instead, we're given these two interior angles, and then this out here, which we call the exterior angle, obviously because it's outside of the triangle, sort of like a little tail on the triangle. So, unlike last time, we are not adding all three angles together to equal 180. Instead, what turns out to be true is that if I were to take these two interior angles and add them together, they'll be equal to this one exterior angle. So let's use that fact to help us set up an equation to find x. So once again, I'm going to add up my two interior angles, and they have to be the two interior angles that are not next to the outside one. So in other words, I don't want that one. So I'm going to add up my two interior angles, x plus 70. I'm going to put that equal to the one exterior angle, 2x minus 5. Notice there's no 180 in this problem. We're not adding up angles to equal 180. It's the two interior ones are equal to the sum of the two interior ones are equal to the one exterior angle. So from here, let's go ahead and solve for x. So I'm going to subtract x from both sides to get those together. 2x minus 1x is just x. At the same time, I'm going to add 5 to get my constants out of there. And, well, just like that, I have x. X is equal to 75. Now, x isn't an angle, so I'm not going to put a degree symbol on it. But don't stop there with the problem. Notice my direction was, after I found x, go back and find the measure of all the angles. So, knowing x, let's plug that back in to figure out what my two angles are. So, this top angle in the triangle, well, that's easy. That's just x, so that's 75 degrees. And now, to find this exterior angle, there's two ways I can do it. We've already said that that exterior angle should be equal to the sum of the two interior angles. Well, now that I know them, let's just add 75 and 70 together. This exterior angle should be 145 degrees. A great way to check this, though, would be let's actually, you know, also plug in 75 for x and see if it also works out to be 145. And sure enough, 2 times 75 is 150. Subtracting 5 also gets me 145 degrees.